Hey guys, this is Raghav, and in this video, I'm going to explain everything you need to know about conditionals in Terraform. How do you create resources based on a certain condition? How do you enable or disable a module based on the value of a certain variable? How do you filter out resources to create from a list based on a certain condition? By the end of this video, you will know exactly how to write Terraform code so that it works based on conditions you supply. So let's get started. The important thing to know is that Terraform doesn't provide any if-else statements like you have in traditional programming languages. That is because HashiCorp Configuration Language, HCL, the language that Terraform uses, is a declarative programming language. And in a declarative programming language, you tell the computer what you want, and you let the computer worry about how to achieve that result. That is why you tell Terraform that you want an EC2 instance, and then Terraform goes and figures out what API calls to make, what logic to execute, to finally get that EC2 instance up and running. The opposite of this is imperative programming languages. That is where you tell the computer how to achieve something. The traditional languages that we work with, like Java, C++, Python, these are all imperative programming languages. But of course, the Terraform developers also understood that oftentimes we just want to create resources based on certain conditions. Like, let's say if the environment is prod, then create 3 instances. Else, if environment is dev, then only create 1 EC2 instance. So they've provided ways to express conditionals declaratively. The most important thing you need to know here is the concept of conditional expressions in Terraform. So the way you define a conditional expression in Terraform is to use the ternary operator. And this is the general format: condition, true value, false value. Whatever the condition is, evaluate it. If the return value of this condition is true, then return this. If it is false, return this. And you've probably seen this ternary operator expression in other languages such as C and C++ as well. Simple example. (10 == 10, which is my condition. If true, yes. If false, no. Okay. This should give me what? Yes. Correct. Okay. Another quick example. 10 > 20. This should also give me yes. Yes. But this one should give me no. Correct. Also, if I just simply put true, will also give me yes. So you get the idea. And whatever value is returned by evaluating this entire conditional, you can assign it to a variable, or you can just directly give it to an argument in Terraform. So this is the basic building block. You will use this conditional a lot. Cool. The next important concept is the count argument in Terraform. By default, when you write a resource definition, Terraform will create one resource out of that. You write EC2 instance configuration, it will create one EC2 instance for you. Count lets you specify the number of resources to create from the same resource definition. So if I write a resource configuration for my EC2 instance, but I say count equals 4, then it's going to create 4 AWS EC2 instances, and it's going to use the same configuration for all of them. Now the fun part is that if you specify count equals 0, then Terraform does not create any resource. Even though you have a full resource definition here, 0 means Terraform won't create any resource. So now how do you create resources based on condition? The trick is to combine count with conditional expressions. So let's go straight to an example. So in this example, I am just creating a simple local file using Terraform. So if I run it, it will just try to create one file, and that's all. Good. Now let's say I want to create this file only if a certain variable is set to true, right? Let's say my user is supplying the variable, and if the user supplies yes, true, then I create this file. Otherwise, I just don't create this file. Okay, let's do that. created inside the example directory. Yep. Good. Let's start by giving it false. Okay. I have defined the variable, create the file, and I've given it a value. And the value of this determines whether I want to create the file or no. Right? I go ahead. Let's put the count equals, let's start with 1, which is the default value, right? Instead of 1, what I'm going to do is write a condition, var dot create the file. Create the file will be either true or false. If it is true, then we go ahead and create one file. But if it's false, we go ahead and say 0. Okay, so now if the value of create the file is true, it returns 1, so count equals 1. But if the value is false, it returns 0, count equals 0. And now my variable's value will determine if we end up creating a file or not. Since we have given false right now, it'll return 0, so count equals 0. There will be nothing created. Let's try that out. Nope. Terraform doesn't need to create anything. But how about now? Yep. Now it is going to create a file. So this is how you can determine whether to create a resource in Terraform or not based on a variable's value. And it doesn't have to be just a variable's value. You could replace this variable with even more complex conditional expressions if you wanted. So let's just say that we have a variable called environment. Okay. And if environment is prod, then we will need to create two files over here. But if environment is anything other than prod, then we only need to create one file, and that's all, right? Let's do a new count. Count equals 2 or 1, right? Environment equals prod question mark. This is what the condition looks like. Now, if the value of environment is prod, if this condition is true, return 2, which means count equals 2. So we will create 2 local files. Otherwise, create only 1 local file, and that's good enough. Okay. Right now, since I've supplied prod, it's going to create 2 local files. But of course, the problem is, in such a condition, if it tries to create 2 files with the same name, that's a conflict. But we can very quickly resolve that. We can say count.index. Now it's going to create 2 files in case the environment is prod. And it's only going to create 1 file, if not. But either way, there'll be a count.index attached to the local file's name. Let's try that. Yeah, so it tries to create 2 files, right? One is called local file 1. The other is called local file 0. Now, if I say anything else, dev, right? Let's try to plan again. And this time, it'll only try to create 1, which will be called local file 0. So that's how conditionals will work. You combine count argument with conditional expressions to create 0 or more resources. Now you can use this same technique to also enable or disable modules in your Terraform code. In this example, I'm using an EC2 module to create an EC2 instance. And if, let's say, I introduced a variable like create new environment, right? It's a Boolean type, true or false. And I used count here and did the conditional thing. Then I could implement a condition like create new environment. If it's equal to true, then count equals 1. Otherwise, count equals 0. And that way, it would enable or disable this module entirely. something like that. Now, sometimes in order to create multiple resources in Terraform, you're not using the count argument. Instead, you're using the for each argument. The for each argument takes a map or a set of items, and then for each item in that map or set, it'll create a separate resource. So in this example, I have defined a map of files where the key is the name of the file and the value is the contents of the file. And then I'm taking this map, and using this map, I'm creating a bunch of files, right? Very simple usage for each local files. I just provided it map. And for each of these files defined here, it'll create the file and content, like the file with the file name and the content as we have already described above. Okay, so you can see that it is going to try to create three different files. Local file B, local file A, and do not create the three things that I've defined here. Now let's say that I only want to create all these three files if a certain condition is true, okay? And for simplicity's sake, again, we'll just take the value of a variable. So let's say create all files, okay? Let's just say we have a variable create all files. And if it is true, then we will create all the files. If it is false, we will not create any of these files. Okay. Again, it's a very simple thing. Create all files. If true, then return the local files map. Okay. Otherwise, simply return empty map. So this is an all or nothing situation. You either create all the files defined in the map, or in general, you either iterate through all the items defined in this map that you provide to for each, or you simply supply an empty map, which means Terraform will run, this resource code will get executed, but since the map is empty, it will not create any resources. So an empty map or an empty list returned to for each is the equivalent of returning zero to count. Okay, let's try it. Right now, the create all files value is true. So I expect that all these files will be created. Yeah, okay. But if I set it to false. Okay. Now, even though I have files defined, I'm expecting that this condition will fail. It will return an empty map. So none of the resources will get created. Yeah, correct. None of them were created. This is how you can supply a zero value to for each, right? But let's take a slightly more complex example here. What if you don't want to create all the files listed in this map, right? You only want to create certain files based on some criteria. So essentially what we are telling is filter out some of the items and only create files for some of those and don't create files for the others. So how do you perform filtration based on your conditions? In such a situation, what we can do is, here is the whole map that we supply to for each, right? We can supply a filtered map to for each, right? Not the whole map, but a filtered map. And how do you filter out a map? You use the for expression and include the if clause inside it to specify a condition. So let's see how. Okay, let's start by this. Okay, first of all, what did I do here? To for each, I supplied a map ultimately, okay? How do I construct this map? I just say, I run a for expression, okay? For each key value inside the local.files. Local.files is once again a map, key and value. I simply just assign key to value again, right? So there's nothing special I've done. I've just reconstructed the map that's already constructed here. Good. That's okay. And this map gets returned to for each. Now is where we will run our filtration logic. I add an if clause here. Okay. And the condition I have is, if the name of the file is do not create, then I don't want to create that file, right? But for any other file name, yeah, I'm happy to create that file. So if k equals do not create, do not create. Okay. So what we have done here is, we construct the map as it is, but we also include an if clause that if this condition is met, then you include the key value. Otherwise, you don't include the key value in the map that you're constructing here, right? So if this condition matches, which means key, which is the file name, if the file name is not do not create, right? Which means if the file name is local file A, good, local file B, yes, then you add them to the map. But if the file name is do not create, don't add it to the final map, right? Once this map gets constructed, it gets returned to for each. And so this is the new filtered out map that will be used by for each. And so it will only create those files. So let's see this in action. This time I see it only wants to create two files. Let's see which one. Local file B, yes, good. And local file A. So there is no file which was defined here, do not create, but this file was not in the final plan that Terraform tried. Why? Because we filtered it out. And I know this looks really complex, but that's the cost of doing it declaratively. So this way, if you're using for each in your Terraform resources, you can choose what kind of conditions you want to apply. You can either have that kind of use case where you want to omit all the files, like, or you want to omit all the items from your map or your list and simply create nothing. Or you want to filter out some of those items from your map or list, in which case you use something like this. It all depends on your use case. Awesome. So to recap, first we learned why Terraform doesn't straight up give us an if-else block. Then we understood conditionals in Terraform using the ternary operator and how to combine them with count and for each arguments to create resources based on conditions. Finally, we also saw how to filter out certain elements based on a condition. I hope you found my video insightful. Don't forget to share it with your friends. Give it a like. Show me all your support. I make a lot of content to teach you practical DevOps. If you're new here, subscribe now. Keep learning. See you next time.